Leave Scarborough Shoal now. That's a demand of the Philippine government following China's latest aggression at sea. The Foreign Affairs Department says it protested China's latest use of water cannons on a Philippine mission delivering supplies to fishermen near Scarborough Shoal on April 30. The DFA also directed China to leave Bajo de Masunlok immediately. But China is defying the order, claiming the shoal, which it calls Huangyandao, belongs to Beijing. It also justifies the actions of its Coast Guard, claiming the Philippine vessels went near Bajo de Masunlok without China's permission. China also slammed other countries supporting the Philippines, saying they do not represent the international community. A 2016 arbitral ruling already invalidated Beijing's sweeping claims in the South China Sea and declared Scarborough Shoal a common fishing ground of China, Vietnam, and the Philippines. But China continues to ignore that decision. Meanwhile, the Philippine Coast Guard says the BRB Bagakay, the ship directly hit by China's water cannons, sustained over 2 million pesos worth of damage. The ship's communication and navigation systems were hit in the attack. Railings, which were built to be sturdy for trainings, were also damaged. Repairs will start as soon as possible.
Hindi yan nagagalaw sa sobrang tigas nitong bakal na to. Kasi ginagawa natin to parang pang close quarter battle kapag ka umakyat yung mga US Armed Forces, especially yung US Coast Guard, pero hindi ito na nagagalaw. Pero ngayon, sa sobrang lakas ng tubig ay nabuwal at nasira pati yung LED screen display natin. Kung sa ito po yung nagwe-welcome o yung nagbibigay ng babala, hindi pwedeng mangisda dito sa lugar na to. Ito yung LED screen natin na kung saan natin binobroadcast sa kanila yung mga gusto nating sabihin.
The PCG earlier said they were advised not to retaliate against China's harassment. Unlike China, which has a Coast Guard law that allows its maritime forces to use lethal force against foreign ships, the PCG says their actions are dictated by the national government.
So far, ang instruction ay don't stoop to their level, maging professional at ingatan lang ng mga tauhan namin, yung kanilang mga sarili na hindi sila madisgrasya. Walang bola sa Philippine Coast Guard, hindi sa amin nanggagaling yung direksyon kung ano ang susunod na hakbangin ng pamahalaan. Merong mas mataas na agency.
The Philippine military fails to intercept a Chinese-flagged vessel that was believed to be doing unauthorized research off the coast of Samar Island. The Navy says the Shenkuo has already left the area of responsibility of the military's Visayas Command. The Chinese vessel was observed while deploying equipment in the waters near Catanduanes province. The military says its attempts to contact the Shenkuo's crew were unsuccessful. Maritime patrols of the Philippine Air Force are trying to confirm the vessel's location.
We conducted radio challenges to the vessel and yun nga, wala tayong monitored na personnel on the main deck. And there are also no responses to all of our communications that we've been trying to conduct with them. So it says two things, no? Either talagang ayaw nila mag-engage or either it's actually a vessel in distress. That the vessel already turned off its AIS. So kaya visuals na lang talaga yung how we would be monitoring.
Turning now to the ongoing Balikatan drills, Filipino and American troops launch multiple rockets from an advanced U.S. weapon system. Katrina Domingo reports.
Scenes from today's Balikatan exercises seem to have been plucked out of an action movie as the United States High Mobility Artillery Rocket System, or HIMARS, made its way to Philippine shores through a hovercraft that crept from the sea straight into the shores of Palawan. The HIMARS proved its all-weather capability as it fired 12 guided multiple-launch rockets into floating targets some 8,500 meters away from the shore, its minimum firing range. This was the opening salvo of the maritime defense drills held in the village of Kampong Olay in the town of Rizal in Palawan.
We are simulating a threat coming from the seas to our shorelines. And so we are using our multi-domain capabilities to defend our sovereignty.
After the launching of a dozen rockets, U.S. and Philippine troops spent about half an hour continuously firing multiple rifles, automatic grenade launchers, and 105mm howitzers to subdue the make-believe seaborne targets.
You see each of these systems working together, and it's also our procedural interoperability as you look at how we employ these systems. Really great demonstration of that interoperability and that partnership that really defines Balikatan.
After the drills held on the west coast of Palawan facing the West Philippine Sea, military officials clarified that these exercises were not designed to threaten China, which continues to illegally occupy parts of the Philippines' exclusive economic zone.
This is quite a distance, and we are only firing within our maritime zones and our territory.
Meanwhile, the local government of Rizal Town also held evacuation drills for some 100 households residing near the Balikatan exercise area.
Isa din po yon sa layunin ng ating pamahalang bayan na magiging ready sila at maintindihan nila yung mga sitwasyon na ganito. Na hindi sila magpapanik, at least magiging ready sila at prepared sila sa kahit anuman, hindi man ito or anumang sakuna or calamities na darating. If it is man-made or natural.
Some military officials say they are satisfied with this year's iteration of the Balikatan exercises, the largest military drills between traditional allies Washington and Manila.
They have shown that they are at par with our foreign counterparts in doing what is necessary to be done.
Now, all eyes are on the leadership on whether or not the Philippines will finally procure its own HIMARS units this year, a weapon that has long been on the military's wish list. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News, Rizal, Palawan.
Now, other political parties backing a possible alliance with President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s Partido Federal ng Pilipinas. House lawmakers from Nacionalista Party and Lakas CMD, which is led by the president's cousin, House Speaker Martin Romualdez, believes the move will once again ensure unity among political factions.
Hindi naman hadlang no na makipag-alyansa ang aming partido sa partido ng ating pangulo dahil ang common agenda ay ang serbisyo at demokrasya para sa bansa.
This really just appropriate na under this a coalition alliances between the parties, di ba po, na we continue on that path of unity for the sake of progress, for the sake of development in our country.
Meanwhile, PFP President and South Cotabato Governor Reynaldo Tamayo says Vice President Sara Duterte's hukbong ng pagbabago can still join the alliance despite not being included in the negotiations.
Ang unit team nanatiling andyan, unit team. Pero yung agreement nag-end, right after election. So ibig sabihin, magbubuo ulit ng bagong agreement. Every party are welcome to join Partido Federal ng Pilipinas. Even Hugpong, kung kinakailangan na they are willing to join, okay naman.
Davao Representative Patalyon Alvarez set to face a congressional probe over alleged violations, including his call for the military to withdraw its support for President Marcos. The complaint, filed by Tagum City Mayor Ray Oy, alleges Alvarez committed disorderly behavior as well as violations of the code of conduct of the lower chamber.
There are basically three allegations. Number one, continued unjustified absences. Number two, the libelous remarks and speeches made by Representative Alvarez against his fellow government officials, particularly the Vice Governor of Davao del Norte and other local officials. And number three, seditious remarks, no, calling for the withdrawal of support of the AFP and the PNP to the administration of President Bongbong Marcos. The committee was able to determine that the complaint is sufficient in form and in substance, and therefore the case against Representative Pantaleon Arbeles will proceed.
The Davao lawmaker had urged the armed forces last month to pull out their support for Marcos as he expressed concerns about the president's stand on the West Philippine Sea issue. The AFP was quick to reaffirm its loyalty to Marcos. The Philippine Transportation Department vows to buy old jeepney units from drivers who do not consolidate as part of the government's PUV modernization program. The DOTR says it sees a growing number of traditional jeepneys being sold for scraps in Metro Manila, priced between 38,000 to 50,000 pesos. The agency plans to buy these vehicles at a higher price. Transport regulators say the consolidation rate is currently at 81%, with only about 600 unconsolidated jeepney units in Metro Manila. But Transport Group Manibela disputes the figures.
Dito po sa NCR, nasa 20,000 pa po ito mahigit. Tingnan, mali yung mga datos na binibigay sa kanila. Kasi kung tama po yung datos, wala pong may stranded na pasahero.
Meanwhile, advocacy group Alt Mobility PH urges the Marcos administration to ensure livelihood support for unconsolidated jeepney drivers. It also wants the government to closely monitor the implementation of the PUV modernization program. The total Philippine debt now below the 15 trillion peso mark. The Treasury Bureau reported Thursday the country's sovereign debt declined by 1.7% in March to 14.9 trillion pesos, down from February's 15.2 trillion pesos. Government attributes this decrease to the payment of domestic government securities, which offset the weakening peso's effect on foreign currency domestic debt. Nearly 6 billion pesos worth of crops in the Philippines are reportedly lost because of the extremely dry El Nino weather. The Philippine Agriculture Department says rice made up of half of the losses. But it notes only 2.17% of the country's rice fields have been affected by the dry spell.
Magkakaroon ng price impact kung yung papasok na imported ay masyado ring mahal at yung local production mo kulang, so definitely magkakaroon yun ng impact. So ngayon naman, hindi naman masyadong mataas yung presyo sa international market compared last year.
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Veronica Torres. Hi, Veronica.
Hi, Bettina, and all of our audience in ANC. So currently, easterlies is still affecting the country, so we're expecting hot and humid weather throughout the whole country. And for the weather condition for Metro Manila and the rest of the country, we're still expecting partly cloudy to cloudy skies with chances of localized thunderstorms. We don't have any gale warning risk over any parts of the country, and we're not expecting any low pressure area, or we're not monitoring any low pressure area or tropical cyclones near inside the Philippine area of responsibility. For the update regarding heat index, the highest recorded yesterday was 48 degrees Celsius over the Gupan City, Pangasinan, and Apari, Cagayan. And for the forecast for today, the highest heat index for the forecast is at the Gupan City, Pangasinan also, and Apari, Cagayan. And that's the latest from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. Veronica C. Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Veronica.